Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Unit Testing. In this series, I'm going to talk about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In this video, I'm going to give an introduction on Jasmine framework. Let's start. Unit testing is a software development process in which the individual units or components of a software are tested. Unit testing ensures that all code meets quality standards before it's deployed. Unit testing saves time and money and helps developers write better code more efficiently. Unit testing is carried out during the development of an application, and usually developers are responsible of doing unit testing. There are frameworks available for conducting unit testing in applications developed in different technologies. For example, we have JUnit, which is an unit testing framework for Java. Like that, Angular ships with Jasmine. Jasmine is a testing framework that supports behavior-driven development. Jasmine uses Kerma to run tests. Kerma is the default test runner for applications created using Angular CLI. Kerma controls the creation of HTML files, the opening of web browsers, the execution of tests, and the return of test results to the command line. Okay, let's see how we can perform unit testing in Angular. First, let me create one Angular application using CLI. Okay, it is created. Let me open this application in VS Code. We can see we have only one module, which is also called the root module. In this module, we can see we have a file called app-component-spec-ts. This spec file is responsible for unit testing. If I open this spec file, you may not understand this code at this moment. But let me explain this in a high level. In Jasmine, our tests are known as specifications or specs, and they are grouped in test suites. So here, each one of these is specification. And this is test suite. And so we can see we have three specs in this suite. Let me get into our project folder. We usually use ngserve to start the application. But now let me use ngtest command. This will start our unit testing. And we can see Kerma is starting a server and it is running the Jasmine test and showing the results in a browser. We can also see the test is completed. Three specs are executed, zero failures. One thing to note here is this Kerma test runner is running in hot reload mode. That means if I change anything in the spec, it automatically reruns the test. But sometimes it won't reflect. We may need to stop the test and rerun. Let me comment one spec. Now we can see it is automatically running again. And now we could see only two specs are executed. In case we don't want to run in hot reload mode, we can use the command ngtest --no-watch. But let's use hot reload mode now, so that we don't want to run it manually every time. And the name of the spec file is important. It should be in this naming convention with the extension spec.ts. If I change the name, we should see no specs found. Let me fix the name. Now we can see the test results again. Okay, let me create a new component using CLI. We can see the spec file for that component is also created. Now we can see two specs in app component and one spec in home component are executed. And if you don't want to do unit testing for any component, you can either delete the spec file manually, or else while creating the component itself, you can include this flag --skip-test. This will not create the spec file itself. Okay, let's deep dive into the spec file. Services are the best place to start learning unit testing. So let me create a service file. Okay, both service file and its spec file are created. We are able to see calc service spec file here. Now let me delete everything from this spec file because we are going to create from scratch. In this service, let me create a function which is going to multiply two numbers and return the result. We need to test this function. First, let me create the test suite. For that, we need to use the describe function in Jasmine. We need to give a description for this test suite. Let me use the same name as service. Then we need to use an arrow function. Inside this function, we can have any number of test specifications. Let me create one. To define a specification, we need to use the it function. Here also, first we need to give a description for the specification. Usually, we give a sentence to identify the specification easily. Here our functionality is to multiply two numbers. So we can give the description as should multiply two numbers. So that we can read it as it should multiply two numbers. And the next argument is going to be a function. Inside this function, we need to create an instance of this service using the new operator like this. Then we can call the function using that instance. And let me pass two numbers, 3 and 5. And let me store the output in a variable. This is going to be the expected result. So in the next line, let's verify whether the expected result is coming. For that, we can use the expect utility from Jasmine. Expect result to be 15. This expect utility is having many functions like to be truthy, to be falsey, to be greater than, etc. For this scenario, we can use to be. So we can see the test is getting passed. But assume the developer has changed something and done some mistake. Instead of multiplication, the developer has used addition by mistake. Now we can see the test is failed. It clearly says expected 8 to be 15. Using this, we can easily fix the bug. This way, we can catch and fix the bugs during development phase itself. This is how we can do unit testing in Angular. In the upcoming videos, we are going to see how we can do unit testing on more complex services and components having dependencies, how to simulate user interactions, asynchronous testing, and many more. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and support me. Thank you. Bye.